Hi, I'm George Crump, lead analyst with Storage Switzerland. We're in Mountain View, California, at the offices of Atlantis Computing. We're talking about their new software-defined storage product, Atlantis USX. It promises to deliver all-flash performance and features at about half the cost of the traditional SAN. Joining me to help with some of the conversation today is Chetan. He's the CTO and founder of Atlantis. Thanks for joining us today, Chetan.
My pleasure, George.
Awesome. So, you know, in our last video, we talked a little bit about deduplication and how that can even help performance, but clearly you guys do more than just deduplication to accelerate I/O performance. Can you talk us through some of the things that you guys do?
Yeah. So deduplication is a very, very clever optimization that we leverage throughout the I/O path. We basically do deduplication right up front on all data that comes in. And once you've reduced data with deduplication and you've compressed it, there are lots of clever things you can do. Like you can tier it more intelligently. You can tier it in a lot less high performance media such as flash or RAM. But more importantly, what we've got is content awareness that we've built as a result of that deduplication.
So you understand the kind of the aspects of the data itself.
We understand a bunch of things. For example, okay. In this, if you look at this schematic over here, what I've got is a bunch of VMs, and we're showing you sort of the composite blocks of those VMs.
Okay.
And as you can see from the colors, the VMs share a lot of common blocks. So one of the things that we do in our tiering, for example, is take that awareness of which blocks are shared by which VMs and how regularly they're accessed to completely change the way data is tiered and data is moved, relegated down into the capacity tier or moved up into the performance tier.
Okay.
In traditional storage, the algorithms are fairly lightweight, if you think about it. They just do it based on the frequency of a block access, or they do it based on recency.
Sure.
But really, they have no knowledge of what's happening at the VM level, what the composition actually looks like from the VM standpoint, and so they can't really do anything smart as far as the content goes.
So clearly, you guys have that content awareness, and so what does that give you?
What it gives you is the ability to basically service 90 to 95% of all I/O requests from the performance tier, rather than need to go down over here.
Okay.
Even across very large data sets. So historically, really your data set in memory was a fraction of the data set that was actually on disk. And so you would need to, you'd essentially miss on the tier and then you need to go down to fetch it.
Right.
What we have is the ability to amplify the tier through deduplication and compression and then change the policies around how data moves between the tiers in such a way that practically 90 to 95% of all I/O requests always get serviced from this tier. Lower latency is the biggest impact. Latencies that are between 800 microseconds to a millisecond in general. But I think the single biggest trick we pull off, George, is the fact that we can handle write I/O, which is the most problematic aspect of all of this,
sure,
far more elegantly and quickly than any other way that you can do from a physical hardware standpoint.
And that's your coalescing capability?
That's the coalescing capability, okay, as well. So let me just illustrate the life of the I/O. So as you know, deduplication will reduce this block footprint down to something very, very unique. So you'd have only one copy of the blue blocks, one copy of the purple blocks, and then one copy of the red blocks over here. And the algorithms are now looking at the access patterns of these different types of blocks and deciding what should be tiered where. So for example, it probably sees that the blue block is not as popular as the purple block, which is the most popular one. Ah. So it will basically create a special policy for the purple block and tier it over there.
Right, and then that's because you've got essentially more copies of it, right?
Exactly.
And that's what you mean by the kind of the simple things. They wouldn't realize that there's more copies of a particular block and therefore less likely to be accessed.
Exactly.
Got it. Okay, exactly. That's very interesting. Okay.
And so you'd still have maybe the blue in the tier, maybe some, and maybe red's gotten delegated down, so red's gotten down over here. But the policies based on which we, keep them in the tier are completely different based on that, the histogram that shows how they're shared across.
Okay.
Right? Finally, when IOs are written down into storage, we coalesce them. Our deduplication happens at the 4K block level. The compression happens variable length.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you write things down, you really want to take advantage of the type of media that you have down here. So if you're using spindles, you really want to sequentialize the IO as much as possible,
right,
reduce latency. So what we do in the coalesce really is aggregate blocks over here, try and grow the size to anywhere from 128K to 512K, and then write them down.
So you're writing bigger chunks.
Writing bigger chunks. As a result, you get great. You take advantage of throughput. You take advantage of spindle physics. All of that to allow a tier two storage system, or even cheap local hard drives, to perform along with the stack in a way that's better than an all flash array.
Okay. And then the tier that we're talking about here is a combination of RAM and SSD.
Great question. Yeah, absolutely. So the tier can be RAM, or it can be SSD, or it can be both. can leverage both of them over there.
All right, so great. So you can leverage both RAM and flash depending on your use case and your need. And then you can leverage a hard drive for the kind of the capacity type of stuff that isn't going to be accessed as often. Is that right?
That's absolutely right. So using the right media and the right locality of that media for the right performance. RAM is on each server, so it gives you the best latencies. Server-side flash, again, an extremely fast medium. PCI Express is a great way to do the performance tiers over there. And then spindle, either server attached or on our SAN NAS for the actual capacity.
Okay, thank you very much, Chetan, for explaining that to us.
My pleasure.
So again, what you've seen here is the advantage of being aware of the blocks at a very fine-grained level. It gives you better understanding of how to optimize. So you can make decisions based on where things should go based on the frequency that they appear in the algorithm. So very fascinating capability. It gives a huge advantage when you're optimizing for performance. Thank you for joining us today. I'm George Crump, lead analyst with Storage Switzerland.